Anyone who's ever used a computer to browse the internet before has run into the problem of wanting, or needing, to look at something, but not wanting someone else to be able to see what you viewed. This may be for the obvious reason of looking at porn online without getting caught by your significant other, but it may also be for the far less obvious reason of looking for a Christmas or birthday present without the recipient finding out. To get around this problem, many people delete their browsing history and temporary internet files after they browse the net. This accomplishes the goal, but all history information is gone, making it obvious someone is trying to hide something. Internet Explorer, as well as other web browsers, offer a private browser option. Microsoft calls its version of this, Internet Explorer, InPrivate Browsing. InPrivate Browsing protects your online privacy by not storing your browsing history, temporary internet files, form data, cookies, and username and password data from within an InPrivate Browsing session. You can start InPrivate Browsing in several different ways. We'll cover a few of them here. First, let's open a new Internet Explorer window. Option 1. With Internet Explorer as the selected current window, we can press a keyboard combination. A keyboard combination is a set of two or more keys that are pressed together at the same time to perform a function on your computer. The keyboard combination here to open InPrivate Browsing is Control-Shift-P. You press these all at the same time. We can see that as soon as the keyboard shortcut is pressed, a new Internet Explorer window opens. In the Internet Explorer pane, it shows InPrivate is turned on. It will also have a blue box with white lettering showing InPrivate to the left of the address bar. This is how you can tell you are using InPrivate Browsing. The second way we will cover opening an InPrivate Browsing session is through a new browser tab. We can click the New Tab button or use the Control key keyboard shortcut to open a new tab. As many of you probably have used before, there are the 10 standard tile links for your most popular sites. What many people probably didn't notice was the link below these tiles for InPrivate Browsing. Let's click this link. It will again open a new Internet Explorer window with InPrivate Browsing turned on. The last way that we're going to cover opening an InPrivate Browsing session is the method that I always use, but this will require that you have Windows 7. You also need to have Internet Explorer pinned to the Quick Start bar. The icons just to the right of the Start menu are the Quick Start tiles. If you don't have Internet Explorer here, you can just drag it from the desktop or the Start menu to the Quick Start bar. To open a new InPrivate Browsing session, right-click on the Internet Explorer icon in the Quick Start bar, and then select Start InPrivate Browsing. Let's see what happens if we go to a web page without using InPrivate Browsing. If we go to the address bar and start to type in the web address, it will attempt to auto-complete it if we've gone there before. For instance, we've already been to jacktutorials.com in this browser, so when we start to type it, it will attempt to auto-complete it. We have not been to the weather.com website, so if we start to type this in, it will not auto-complete it. This is often a way that others can tell where you've been. You can also click the drop-down here to see some of the previously visited sites. The only one that's been here since I last cleaned the browsing history was jacktutorials.com, which is why this is the only one showing up here. Now let's go to weather.com. Once that loads, now let's open a new browser tab, and we'll start typing in weather.com in the address bar. We can see that weather.com comes right up. Now let's go through the same test we just did, but this time we'll use InPrivate Browsing. We'll click the New Tab button again, and then select the InPrivate Browsing button. Let's go to another site we haven't gone to before on this computer, like CNN.com, for instance, and press Enter. And All right, now let's close out this InPrivate Browsing session. Now in the address bar, we'll just start to type cnn.com again. And we'll see that it doesn't remember that we were just there. And that's because we were using the InPrivate Browsing session. This was just an example of browsing history not being remembered, but it keeps all other information private as well. You should now have a good understanding of what InPrivate Browsing is and how to use it to browse the internet while keeping your session information private.